Hi, it's Bernie Slavin here. Thanks for joining me on my YouTube channel. If you like what you see, please subscribe. It's free. Several years back, I travelled down to London. As I say, I used to do Borough TV for a number of years. And I used to interview players, managers, past, present, celebrities, whatever. On this occasion, I travelled down to London to talk to Craig Johnson. Craig Johnson was an Australian. Joined Middlesbrough under Jack Charlton. He discusses that in the chat coming up. Then he went to Liverpool and he won a few trophies there. But he was also known not just for his football and ability, but he was the brain behind the iconic Adidas Predator boot. You remember that? The Adidas Predator boot? All the kids wanted them. I think I had a pair. Anyway, sit back and enjoy Craig Johnson. And if you like what you see in the YouTube channel, please subscribe.
This week in Bernie's About, we're here in Buckinghamshire to talk to Craig Johnson. You decided to write a letter to the club. You know, was that your idea?
Well, I saw them on television and Middlesbrough toured and I was in hospital. I had a very bad leg operation and I'd been in hospital for about 6 months. And then I saw Middlesbrough playing. Jack Charlton was the manager and people like Peter Bryan and Stuart Boehm and Alan Foggan, and now we're going back. Spikey Armstrong was bald then. I think he was only 17. But David Mazzetta, and it really captured my imagination. The fact that they were so close to me, I was in a hospital bed and I could almost see where they were playing. It was on television. And I fell in love with the concept, so I wrote to them, got my mum and dad to write to them. And Manchester United and Chelsea, and Middlesbrough was the only one that wrote back, and it was Harold Shepherdson. Yes. And he said, well, yeah, come over, late Harold Shepherdson, if you pay your fare and your board and lodgings, we'll see how good you are. And I was there for about a week and they said, you're no good, you have to go home. So I started crying and saying, let me stay, I'll prove it to you, I'll prove it to you. So I paid to stay in the Medhurst, and I sort of didn't get better for a long time, about a year before they discovered I was still there. But I'd clean the boots for nothing and I'd, do the jobs the apprentices didn't want to do so that they wouldn't dob me into the management that I was still sort of hanging about. It worked like that until Jack Charlton came. And then he told me in no uncertain terms. And he had a go at everybody around the dressing room. He said, you kangaroo, like that, whatever your name is. He said, you will never be a footballer while your arsehole points to the ground. That's what he said, that's the honest. And I went, I was convinced from that that I would prove this guy wrong. I would prove him that I actually could play. Well, about a year after Charlton had left and John Neil, I had two or three games in the first team and played really well. And then the newspaper said, Jack Charlton, I always knew he'd be good. So he claimed responsibility, as you talked to her earlier.
You made your Borough debut against Everton in 1978. Any memories of that debut?
The two memories that stand out is the first time I was ever a footballer, which is what you're talking about, that Everton match. And the second one was scoring the FA Cup final against Everton again. So, yeah, it means a dreadful lot to me. I mean, I could have never played football ever again after that two or three moments where I stood out there and said, hey, it's me. And, you hear the crowd and the ball comes to you and you do something, you flick it, and then the crowd responds to the flick and you go, whoa. Yeah, what a buzz. Hard to explain, but you know how it works.
Was Graham Souness, was he a bit of an idol? Did you look at him as...
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, he was a total inspiration. I was his boot boy, and I think he remembered fondly the trip to Australia So he actually looked after me. He made it his business to look after me and make sure that nobody was really taking the mickey out of me.
Right. Was he one of the tough lads?
Simnes was the tough lad. He was the kiddie, the organiser, the general on the field and off it. You know, and it had a lot to do with the style of Middlesbrough in those days. So when he left for Liverpool, he fixed me up with his digs and the famous Phoebe Haig down on Chipchase. And Alan Murray was part of that gang, and I stayed there for 2 or 3 years, and they really looked after me incredibly well.
Souness to Murdoch. That's for Craggs, who got well forward. Mills. Souness. Oh, beautiful shot by Graham Souness.
What would you say your game was all about? Was it pace, skill, work rate, or a mixture? Obviously, you worked hard at your game.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it was the deficiencies I always had was skill and tactical awareness and football intelligence, you know, and they're very tangible things that the great players possess. And because I didn't have any of them in any particular quantity, I worked on pace, aggression, teamwork, you know, supplying whoever's on the ball with another option, unselfish runs, and, you know, I was accused of being a little bit, you know, tunnel vision, because I was. And, you know, now and again I used to try and, you know, a bit of fancy stuff, because that's what I admired in football, that's what I didn't have. Now and again I come unstuck, but I think over the years I developed from watching good players one or two tricks, and I improved. So I was always pinching myself that I was in the company of such good players at Middlesbrough and Liverpool's. But I've got no hang-ups about how good or bad I was always thought that I was lucky to be there.
Inside it goes. Here's Johnston. Oh, saved by Hansbury. Tipped it over.
After playing 71 games for Borough, scoring 16 goals, Liverpool wanted your signature. Were you surprised it was Liverpool?
Well, it was funny because the team at that time wasn't Liverpool. It was Brian Clough and Nottingham Forest. So they'd come in first, and then Spurs, and then Manchester United. But nobody took any notice of Manchester United back then, seriously. And then Liverpool came in. And the Liverpool connection was is that Souness used to call back quite regularly up to Chipchase and Phoebe, and I said jokingly, you know, if they need a new midfielder down there, you know, give me the nod. So he phoned me up and he said that they'd approached him already, and that they were thinking of replacing Terry McDermott, and would I be interested? I had to find Clough, and Clough was on holiday in France, and I couldn't get a hold of him. So I went to Liverpool, and I was ready to sign. I said, but I have to do one thing, which was to phone Clough, because I said I would. And I tracked him down, and you know, he was the man, you know, behind Forrest. So I thought I was signing for a man rather than Liverpool were the institution. Right. And I thought, well, this is not Bob Paisley I'm signing for. It's that institution, that academy, that heritage. And I'd always been fascinated by the Shankly thing and the Scottishism in Liverpool, and I guess that's what swung it, but Clough wasn't a happy man.
Let me I bet tell he wasn't. No. Between 81 and 88 at Anfield, you won 5 league titles, FA Cup, 4 league cups, European Cup. What was your proudest moment?
All of the above, I guess. You know,
you designed the successful Adidas Predator book. You know, how did that idea come around?
When I retired, I said I'd never get involved in the game again, because I played for Middlesbrough, I played for Liverpool. There's the medals. Done that thing. Someone knocked on the door, a couple of kids with a ball under their arm, and said, Mr. Johnston, can you come and coach our team? We're not very good. So I was hooked. I was back into football. Mm-hmm. So I coached the team, and he was right. They weren't very good. I think we had 12 games, 11 losses. But anyway, during one of the coaching sessions, I was telling them how to swerve a ball. And I said, you've got to grip the ball and pick it up with your boot. So grip it like a table tennis bat. So, but Mr. Johnston, it's raining and the ball's slippery. So it's not like a table tennis bat. And ding, I had the idea. So I went home, got a table tennis bat, put that on the wet leather boots, went out in the rain, and it gripped more. I said, bing, onto something. So I followed it through, spent a fortune on it, got a patent, and took it to actually Nike and Reebok, both who knocked it back. Then I took it to Adidas, and they signed it on. And then while I was there, I was there for 2 years, living in Germany, I created the traction sole and spearheaded all the development of the Questra ball, the World Cup ball.
Do you fancy management, going into management?
I tell you who is a good manager, and the story that I like is the Robson-Gibson combination.
Yes.
And what's happened at Middlesbrough has delighted me, absolutely delighted me, because I think you need that combination. And that, and I'll say the word tragedy, absolute tragedy of turning up late for the match and going down because of it was a travesty of justice in a lot of ways, because the bold and the brave thing had been done. You know, the Nunes, the Janinho, you know, those sort of, not Nunes, Janinho and
Ravinelli,
no, Emerson, that's who I meant, to buy the world's best player. I mean, where's that coming from for Teesside? What a brilliant move. Yeah. It's all been the guts has been done. And I must say, I went to Wembley, went to the Coca-Cola, went to the Leicester, went to the key games to see old friends. But I support Middlesbrough, there's no doubt about it. And the key thing is what happened was shocking. I wrote a letter to Gibson and to Robson just saying how proud, as an ex-Middlesbrough bloke, you know, and someone that lived there for a long time, of what they did do. They did all the hard work, and it was just a cruel twist of fate. But, you know, bounce back, which is fabulous. And, you know, you're just lucky, I reckon, to have people with vision, with track record. And that's all it takes, really, you know. But other clubs don't have it. And I just think you're so lucky to have got that and built this great foundation.